Do you want to know how you can read the Bible and know exactly what it means without second guessing, but being confident in what you're reading? Well, then stick around, because that's coming up. If it is your first time joining me today, then go ahead and hit the subscribe button, because I know you're going to enjoy everything I tell you in this video. It'll be so fantastic to have you again. Hit the like button so I know you got something out of this, but let's begin. So these are ways that help me understand what I'm reading. One of them is I would hold my Bible and give a quick prayer. Lord God, I pray when I open this Bible that it will go straight into my heart, that every word I read is lifted off the page and enters my daily life and helps me understand you more, that my mind won't play a role in this book, that it won't try to come up with wrong interpretations of the meaning. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Simple but powerful, and it can easily impact your reading, rather than being, all right, oh Lord, the depths I cry to you, oh Lord, I hear my failure, gosh, I don't wanna do this. But that you want to, oh Lord, hear my voice, let my ears be attentive to your voice and my pleas for mercy. You hear what I mean? Yeah. Also, if you want to learn how to pray, then go ahead and click this video right here. It'll easily teach you how to pray right now. You have to want the hunger to read and not dragging it on. Not having it on a schedule of once or twice or three times a day, but just doing it when you can. Also, another thing you can do is when you're reading a paragraph and you do not understand it, what I used to do is I would read it and just talk to God and say, hey, I don't understand this paragraph. I would ask God what the meaning of this is, and he will respond immediately. Because he wants to help you learn. He wants to help you understand his word. So you're not getting all caught up in your head or all kinds of things like other people do nowadays. But that the next time you read that paragraph, you'll understand it immediately and you'll get it. Because, I mean, he wants you to know this. He's not gonna leave you hanging there without knowing what this means. I do recommend when you read something and it really stands out to you, or when he tells you the meaning of this, write it down. It's always good to write down things that he tells you or things that you're reading, so you can keep that in your journal and just read it when you want. I also have a video on how to read a Bible. It is very simple. And this video pretty much kind of correlates with that one, but it's very important to have that want to read the Bible. When you're in a relationship with God, you just have that almost need to be with him, you know, like that need that you have to, but not like you have to like, you know, it's not like you're like, yes, I love God, and then like you don't talk to him until like next month, you know what I mean? You know, if you don't have time for reading, if you're at work or whatever, I mean, there's multiple ways you can talk to God, be with him. It's a big, huge want to always be with him, whether it's reading, praying, just flat out talking to him. The more you're active with him, the more clear things are to you, and the more you learn and the more fascination you have with God's love. It's super important to be real with him. Now, I know this video was not super long, and my videos are never really that long, because I just like to get straight to the point on whatever the title is, that you guys get the message fast, so you guys don't have to waste your time with anything else but the preaching itself or information given like today. I just made a video on how to get the perfect Bible for your studies. That's a great video, so you can send it to your friends or even just for you. But go ahead and like and subscribe if you have not already. But also, I just released this shirt. It's one of my favorites. I recommend checking that shirt out. When they hunt me down, I'll stand my ground. The meaning of this shirt is, you know, there's always gonna be conflict with people and Christians. And you know, people are always saying around the world, you know, freedom of speech, freedom of religion. And it's starting to just deteriorate as if that never mattered at all. Seems like Catholics matter and all these other atheists matter, but Christians, they don't matter, okay? So this shirt, you know, whether you agree with Christianity or not, whether you get rid of Christianity in the world, it's not gonna get rid of the Christianity in my heart. You know what I mean? I'm gonna stand with God whether they kill me or not. These people can kill the flesh off your bones, but they can never touch the real you. There's ISIS everywhere killing Christians around the world, but no matter what, guys, nobody can ever steal your faith and your love for God. Nobody can ever take that away. They can take your money, they can take your house, they can kill you and your family, but they can never take your love and faith in God. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in another one. Messenger out.